So children, today we have to start with a new poem. Wishing you a very happy time ahead with this poem. Let us learn something more about nature, about a beautiful relationship between a laburnum tree and a goldfinch bird. Right? So in nature, there are many beautiful relationships existing. So this is one of them. A beautiful relationship between a laburnum tree and a goldfinch bird. This poem is written by Ted Hooks, and the core theme of the poem shows us the beautiful relationship between the two. It starts with a description of the laburnum tree whose top was still and silent. Still means it was not moving and it was silent. Its leaves had turned yellow and the seeds had fallen down. All the leaves of the laburnum tree had turned yellow and the seeds had fallen down. It was daytime in the month of September, and the tree was standing still and not moving. It was like a complete lifeless picture. The tree was completely lifeless, without any life. And suddenly, the lifeless tree becomes alive. All of a sudden, it becomes all alive by the arrival of the goldfinch bird. Goldfinch is a kind of small bird with, bright gold color. Right, and the laburnum tree also has got a bright gold color. So the bright gold color in the goldfinch bird and the laburnum tree creates a very beautiful, a golden picture in the nature. And so you see how beautifully the whole poem portrays or brings out the relationship and the beauty of the relationship between the bird and the tree. She came to feed her younger ones who are on the thickness of the branch, somewhere among the branches, somewhere in between the thickness of the branch and the leaves, the goldfinch bird has its nest. So in the nest, there are small baby birds hidden behind the thickness of the branches, and the tree is her shelter. The tree is whose shelter? The bird's shelter. She arrives at the branch, at the end of the branch, with a chirping sound. So the babies come to know that the mother bird has come. She further moves to the other side of the branch with rapid and precautionary movement, like a lizard. Now, lizard, you must have already seen the movement of a lizard. It is not a careless move. It is very guarded, alert move. So, like the alert movement of a lizard, the bird also moves very carefully. As soon as she arrives, the younger ones start chirping like a machine. The younger ones, they start chirping. They make sound like a machine and vibrating and flapping their wings. So suddenly they all come to know that the mother bird has come. And so the younger ones, they start making sound like a machine and vibrate and flap their wings. The death-like tree, the lifeless tree, becomes alive and it trembles and shakes with the vibration of the birds and their happiness and the flapping of their wings. After feeding them, she flies. Who flies? The mother bird flies to the other side of the branch. Her dark colored face with the yellow body was barely visible as she vanished behind the yellow leaves. She flew away in the sky, leaving the tree death-like again. So once the bird was there, the tree was all alive. And as soon as she leaves, the tree again becomes silent quiet and death-like. So we are going to look at the line-by-line explanation of the poem. The laburnum top is silent, quite still in the afternoon yellow September sunlight. A few leaves yellowing, all its seeds fallen. In the above lines, the poet says that he saw a laburnum tree whose leaves were yellow, and in the month of September, these yellow leaves were looking very beautiful in the yellow September light. And the poet has used the word yellow for both leaves and sunlight. Yellow symbolizes prime, age, and silence, death, and beauty. All these are symbolized with the color yellow. And you know what is the color of youth? Green is the color of youth. And for beauty, death, and silence, we can think of something yellow, right? So he describes the whole scene of the tree with this color, that it was lifeless, it was silent, but it was still beautiful because yellow symbolizes lifelessness or silence, and yet it becomes very beautiful. The color is very beautiful. Till the goldfinch comes with a twitching chirrup, a suddenness, a startlement at a branch end. Then sleek as a lizard and alert and abrupt, she enters the thickness and the machine starts up. Of chitterlings and a tremor of wings and trillings, the whole tree trembles and thrills. Now see, we are coming to the explanations, word meanings and all. It is already entered. You can go through the word meanings at your own time. A goldfinch bird comes to the end of the lifeless tree and makes a sudden chirruping sound. The bird was trying to be very careful, very alert, like a lizard. And slowly she sits on the branches of the tree. As she moves towards the thickness of the branch, her younger ones started chirruping and doing vibrations with wings and making a sound like a machine. Because of the movement of the bird and her young ones, the whole tree starts shaking and vibrating and full of life and beauty. The whole thing became alive. The whole tree became alive. The poet has given us two opposite scenarios of the tree. The first scenario becoming death-like, still, and then giving life and shelter to bird and her young ones. And so we are finding two scenes are there. One is death-like scene, still scene, and suddenly the whole scene changes, that we see life in the tree and providing shelter to the bird and her young ones. It is the engine of her family. She stokes it full, then flirts out to a branch end, showing her barred face identity mask. Now see, what is the engine of her family? It is the nest. The young ones are the engine of her family. And she stokes it full. She gives full feed to the bird. And then she flirts out. She again moves out, okay, to a branch end, showing her barred face identity mask, meaning that now barred face identity mask means the bird, yes. The bird has a dark colored striped face. Okay, barred face is why it is mentioned. It has got a dark colored stripe. Bar, you know, bar, we have we have lines across. So her face is also striped like bars and is visible as her body is yellow colored. The barred face, dark colored face is visible as her body is yellow colored. The yellow colored body is hidden behind the yellow leaves of the tree. But the face is identifiable because it is of dark color. So you can imagine a goldfinch bird. The body is yellow colored and the face is dark colored. So like this, we move to the last stanza. Then with eerie, delicate whistle chirrup whisperings, she launches away towards the infinite and the laburnum subsides to empty. So after reaching the end of the branch, the bird makes a sweet chirruping sound just like whispering and flies away towards the infinite sky. After the bird flies away, it again makes the laburnum tree silent and death-like. Okay, so the literary devices are shared here. Please go through the literary devices, read the poem, and enter the literary devices in your notebook. No need to write the word meanings. Word meanings I have already shared in this lecture. You don't have to write them. You just enter the literary devices and complete the assignment that is going to be uploaded for you, right? That is all for today. I hope you have followed the lecture, you have followed the poem. Just in case if you have doubts in